wonderful treat tonight. I'm sorry there aren't many people here because of the heat and the pork and everything else. Maybe they can come again sometime. But my name is Carolyn Keeley, and my husband bought the store 15 years ago, and he died 3 years ago, and my children, my four children and I have taken over responsibility of the store. And we have a wonderful manager, James. So, and this is a very special night tonight. Patrick is on our is on our board, actually. And this is a group of his that has been playing in many places and has a wonderful CD. Are you having that available to them?
Of course, yes. It's right there.
Oh, there it is, right there. Yeah. My husband felt that this was a really sacred place and a very special place, and he loved it. He was actually a philosopher and taught at Wellesley College, but he loved poetry, and he felt that poetry was going to save the world, so and music too. So welcome. We're happy to have you tonight.
Thank you.
Thanks so much. We are delighted to be here with you. Well, thanks for coming out on this sweltering evening. And wow, we might have to turn that AC back on at some point. Really great to be here. You may have recognized that first poem we played. It's one of William Butler Yeats's. And you may recognize a few other poets that we're going to be touching upon as we go along, including Federico Garcia Lorca, of course.
Partridge, would you mind if people followed the words from the in this CD?
Of
the poems?
Not at all, no. You're welcome to...
It's a wonderful way, because the poems he's reading or singing are quite wonderful.
Welcome to follow along, if you like, absolutely.
If you want to follow in the CD, does anybody want to
In the liner notes, yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
So that's totally your prerogative, whether you want to just simply listen and absorb it or read along.
Would you mind if
they
did that? Would anybody want to follow along? And,
Here's an open one.
There's another one.
So I think this next tune is not on.
Yes, well, having said that, which one is John? Perhaps it will be on the CD in the near future. This one is, like I said, a more recent one, and you will discern it, I think, from called With You.
Strange day, empty streets, get so good at walking away. Thank you.
change it up just a little bit. The poem by Peter Money here.
Down in the shower's one remaining puddle. Their wings, windsurfer sails, caught flat under a soft veil of sea. When I approach, their threads for legs twitch and spin, really like a baby being diapered. There, there now, I begin. And I slip the wedge of something found under their bodies. Instantly, they're agile. They grip, unless they're dead, to what's possible again. As if they hadn't lain there for 2 days modeling for a poem about Emily Dickinson. And although it is cold where I free them, as if feeding minuscule birds through a disintegrating cage. Each by each, they find a chip of lethal paint along the windowsill outside and cling to it until they regain their wit to fight for flight. First feeling a direction, then becoming supreme, and in a second, powering their way across the yard, at which point they care not to be seen. Probably, I suspect, out of embarrassment. Even if I were not alone saving the flies, as morning lightens the empty house, I would be one of them. Honestly, I admire what they have done. Trapped by something attractive. Beaten by the lure of screens whose tiny crossbars look like hatch patterns of hundreds like them. If just their skeletons. They rise. Yes, sometimes needing help. From being dead in the water skunk sputum, a desirable, velvety lethargy of drunkenness. Wet sarcophagi of what remains of effort in oncoming winter, boasting a resilience. Stored and called upon that not even their tribe knew. Because who has time to be sentimental anymore? somebody must. Somebody must be a monk to the least among us. Maybe the language with fingers instead of forks. And I did it because they cried out by being silent. And I forgave them after being annoying and numerous during certain weeks of summer, fall, winter, spring. And I believed it was worth it. Because what is time if not for saving something? And because I can imagine that fly, even my enemy, bereft, defiant, but equally trying to get away, equally hungry.
From a sheaf of bills, saying, "This is all I have."
night, she said, took your hand.
Nat Williams?
Yes.
Partridge, Boswell?
Peter Money? You might have picked a little bit of E. Cummings up on that last. It tends to happen from time to time. It's inevitable how they work their way. I believe there was some Elizabeth Bishop on that second one. Anyway, this next one is all pure Federico Garcia Lorca. I used to play it for you. It's called La Luna Asoma, The Moon Rises. Thank you. sale la luna. Se pierden las campanas y aparecen las sendas impenetrables. Cuando sale la luna, el mar cubre la tierra, el corazón se siente aislado. Nadie come naranjas bajo la luna llena. Es preciso comer fruta verde y naranja. Cuando sale la luna, diciendo rostros iguales, la manera de plata solloza en la ilusión.
Turn your walk away to the playground.
waiting for love.
Place is probably special to each of you because you found it. I know it's special to Partridge because he won the poetry prize here once. It's special to me too because, 1990. Luisa was here, and I came in with my first book in a backpack, and I showed her a copy and nervously asked if she'd like any, and she said, "How many do you have with you?" And I said, "Oh, 7, 8, or 9. She said, "I'll take them all," and she wrote me a check. And I walked on air, and I passed Seamus Heaney, and I thought, yes, we're off. So I, and Carol's husband so sweetly said a prayer for my mom the last time I was here, as I read here, and then I went off to her memorial. So there's something special here, obviously. I wish that something special were everywhere. This poem, these next two poems are from my first book, and they both take place in New York. And unfortunately, this kind of thing that I'm about to read is still happening. You know, and maybe poetry will help, maybe music will help. It's called Behind Me, I Can Hear Them Talking. Cities are good for that. Or the post office in the country. Or the general store. Behind me, I can hear them talking. He's complaining to her. He's saying, you can't even walk, that there are too many people. He says, I wish a disease would come and wipe out half the people. In a kind of bored and monotone type of voice. And I look at him, walking steadily, without stumbling, as though through a field, he and she side by side in synchronicity, and I call out to him as he's moving ahead of me. Would you be one of them? But he doesn't hear me, or it doesn't matter. He was moving just fine. Maybe a bad day. But I'm left standing in front of the Woolworth entrance, staring at him, and wondering what half he thinks he belongs to. Speaking of has. There's a lot to be upset about now, as there was 2 years ago, 20 years ago, 40 years ago. One wonders what brings people to the edge. Hopefully poetry brings us down from the edge, back from the edge, but it's understandable how we get to the edge. To the lady in pink, standing on top of the Brooklyn Bridge. Behind me say hurry, say madness, emergency. The three lanes to Brooklyn, each jammed with drivers, and cops and an ambulance surge onward up the ramp on cathedral gates. You stand high in triforium, an opera of red lights beneath. Loudly the police intercom and traffic, people move to your left or right now. And the white lights of their blue truck search for space to move. A rescue! Headlights deaden my cabbie's face as he turns toward me, enigmatic, and so the cop back on the PA shouts, "Cabbie, use your brains! Now move!" And we must all be fools on this bridge tonight. Oh lady, the lights sent to get you, pink, standing. Will you dive while the cops follow? Your eyes, somewhere upon your figure. In another poem. Lady, I've got to find you. Lady, I'm sorry. They follow your eyes upon the figure. And I wonder, do you use this opportunity as your church, your temple, your mosque, your place? Do you wish this scene gone? Say, I found my God, now leave me alone. All this fuss for your standing. The dispatcher over the cab radio announces, all cars, stay clear of the Brooklyn Bridge. They got a jumper. And to the cabbie, I say, did it look like she was going to jump? We roll down the ramp to Brooklyn, and my cabbie says, maybe. Maybe in the river. I turn to watch a pin drop, see it leap to night sky, but Manhattan's yellow night glow doesn't catch her. And immediately after feeling that close to the jumper, I'm stunned. No longer excited by passing death courage. No longer excited by passing death courage. If only in a car. Maybe her life is saved, or maybe the cops look down. No longer coaxing the dead to live. Oh lady, the lights behind me say madness, emergency, hurry. Oh, I think she saved herself.
Well, it's that kind of a sweltery day, but use a little water to cool off, maybe some seawater. That's maybe lush, something lush and green. Mm-hmm. And dreaming. We're going to dive into a few ballads now. First two by Federico Garcia Lorca. His ballad, The Water of the Seas. This somnambulant ballad, an early ballad, and also known as the Sleepwalker's Ballad, also known as Green, we like to call it Green, and then we'll finish this small set with one of our own ballads called Last Night in America.
And this ballad of the Water of the Sea is very much true to the original, actually, but it's loosely translated by me. Ballad of the Water of the Sea. The sea smiles from far off. Teeth of foam, lips of sky. Yo, clouds, what do you sell from your chest full of breath? I sell, consumer, water.
What are you carrying now, black youth?
Mixed in with your blood? I carry, officer,
the water.
The water of the seas. These salt tears, mama, where do they come from? I weep, your honor, the water of the seas. Heart and its grave, where was it born? How bitter's the water of these seas. The sea smiles. Far off, teeth of foam, lips of sky.
Shadow on the way she dreams from her balcony. Green skin heavenly, eyes of cold silver green. How much I want you, green, beneath the gypsy moon. All things look at her, she cannot see. Thank you. scorching green. Great stars of white cross swim in the fish of darkness. They open a road of dawn. The fig tree rubs the wind with its empty branches. And the mountain bilging cat drizzles its bitter aloe. Thank you. wanted to.
There will be others, but last night. Anyone else need a water break? So who says poetry doesn't rock? Poetry does it all. Oh. Yeah, I don't think you got the memo. That's okay. I'll just follow along.
You're good. You're good.
I'll follow along.
Got our notes here.
I got the door open.
Yeah, you're good.
Ontology as phenomenology. Is that what you're referring to?
Yes, I was.
I had a great teacher at Brooklyn College who taught feminism, feminist literary theory, and phenomenology. And only later did I get to know this thing, ontology. Why not? Ontology. That's phenomenology. Is it a made-up thing? No. It is a lived thing. Waterlogged eyes, conceptual boats. Bring the harvest to hand. From the impossible, possible position of living as a form of question. Of living as a form of question. One begs. Differs.
Just found it. Here's one by David Keenan called Unholy Ghosts.
Thigh, I said, hold it, if I wouldn't know you're leaving. out of your pride. What's got I in something is to the fathers of the lost child, and we are holding on. It's the one who seems best behind. It is manned by a drunkard who's dripping with port, sitting stupefied, nailed to a stool. The man, he catches my gaze and loses his pay from his waistcoat with a slipped knife. Look, boy, here is my last known correspondence with Christ. I try to read it, but my glasses are filthy. Here's to that.
It is on our album. It figures we call it an icon, I don't know. Anti-hero. Anti-hero, at least. Maybe not even anti-hero. A gentleman by the name of Evil Knievel, which some of you may recall, some may not. If you don't, if it doesn't ring a bell, you can look him up. This one, this is called Papa Wheelie. Thank you. is Harper's to Africa, do you think? The Grolier. This institution that is really a womb of words for so many of us who write and live and breathe and love poetry. So, I guess we'll offer this up to the Grolier and to you. Thank you so much for listening. Appreciate it. And we'll end with a poem by W.S. Merwin. God, thanks. Thank you.
long bridges to bow from the bay. You and me out of the classrooms to the house of the to look at the sky and say thank you.
Thank you, everybody. Let's give Los Lorcas another round of applause.
I just want to say that I know that Ifani and Louisa are joining in that. Thank you. With us. Thank you so much.
Thanks
the power of music and beautiful poetry is overwhelming. Thank you.